Hello and welcome back to another Amazing World of Gumball reaction on Season 1, Episode 11. What is this one called? I haven't even had a look. The Laziest, okay, maybe it's about the fucking dad because they basically said in the last episode that he was fucking lazy. Which, speaking of the last episode, what happened? Anais made a painting and the principal's like, oh no, this painting obviously means you just have to fucking fix your family. So they did all this shit and it wouldn't let her just talk. And at the end she was like, yeah, I like the things, the way things are. Okay, the Laziest though, I don't even know what to predict. Maybe it's something to do with the dad? I don't know, like, we might as well just get into it, let's just go.
So remember, you've got to vacuum the living room,
hell yes,
sort out the fridge, and don't forget to take out the trash.
He probably won't.
Commander.
Very good, see you later.
Okay, why are you standing there?
Can't be bothered.
Of fucking course you can't be bothered. Okay, I don't think you have fucking special powers to be able to levitate it. Is he fucking stupid or...
Psst, Dad, play?
Play what?
I can't play right now. Can't you see I'm taking out the trash? How about you little bank robbers take your loot to the safe house? Huh?
I can't just use playing the kids for them doing the fucking things that he had to do.
I'll tell you what, if you can find anyone lazier than me in this town, I'll do your chores for a whole day.
Okay, sure, I mean, I'd be very surprised if they find anyone lazier than this guy.
That's pretty fair.
Okay then, let the lazy off begin!
Hey, you got a little something on your face.
Where?
There!
Just fucking slap him down.
I'm all tingly.
Me too, buddy.
What the hell is happening? Oh, it's the sugar, of course. What the hell? Oh, hell yes. I didn't know sugar fucking wedding your body and sang an epic song, but sure. Oh, yes. That sounds like a fucking Animal Crossing character.
He's just saying he needs to find a guy to beat his pop in a lazy.
What the hell, he can understand?
Who's Lazy Larry?
It's a long story, son.
Okay, God, I don't think we have enough time to hear the whole story, but sure. What the hell?
I don't know.
They're fucking deflated.
Everything is fast now. Everything is slow. I'm all alone in my sugar.
Oh, hell yes. It turned into a fucking sad, depressing country song.
Go and see Lazy Larry. He works at the convenience store.
Okay, sure. Is Lazy Larry that fucking guy that apparently that seems to work at every single store?
Lazy Larry, please come to the checkout. Lazy Larry.
No one calls me that anymore. I stopped being Lazy Larry years ago.
Wait, it is this guy. Okay, sure.
Lazy Larry, leave me alone!
Counting at customers, Needlemeyer. Gonna have to let you go.
What, they made him get fired from his job? Jesus Christ. They're gonna fucking haunt this guy for the rest of his life.
Hi, honey. There's something I've been meaning to...
They're gonna ruin this guy's proposal, aren't they?
Would you...
Please do it, Larry. Please do it, Larry.
Get out of my life!
Okay, yep, they just ruined this guy's fucking entire life.
Lawrence.
It just ruined again, just fucking ruined this guy's life. Made him get fucking lose his job, made his fucked up his own relationship.
We're back in the game! Let's go!
And I've just been stalking this guy the entire day to get him into a fucking lazy
off. That was a pretty long time out.
Yeah, but now we've got someone who can beat you. Lazy Larry!
Lazy Larry, huh? Why, that's a name I haven't heard since the summer of 80.
Oh, nobody cares about the summer!
I kind of do. I mean, I didn't really at first, but I kind of do there.
I'm hungry.
Me too. I think I'll have a slice of pizza.
But if you move, you lose.
Who said anything about moving?
Okay, how the hell? Okay, to be fair, whatever he's doing, if this works, that's actually kind of impressive, I'm not gonna lie. Oh my fucking god, okay, well.
For as little as $9.79,
That is creepy, whatever that statue is.
Must change channel.
Well, shit, okay, I guess if that works.
You're pretty lazy, my boy.
We won? We won!
Yeah, you won after ruining someone's life. Like, ruining their proposal relationship and then making them lose their job.
Watterson, you should be ashamed of yourselves. Fooling around as your poor father slaves away.
Oh my fucking god. Of course. Of course the dad pulls this off. I mean, to be fair though, that is pretty smart. I had a feeling that that was going to be at least somewhat related to the dad. But oh my god, I can't believe Gumball Darwin basically ruined some random person's life. Lazy Larry, or whatever his name actually was. To then just not even, like, have Lazy Larry in the fucking competition or whatever. So they basically ruined the guy's life for nothing. Like, first they ruined his, like, marriage proposal and that. Which makes him, like, basically not be in the relationship at all. Like, she breaks up with him. And then, like, before that, they made him get fired from his job because they kept fucking appearing everywhere. Which, like, what sort of powers do they have to be able to just haunt this guy and, like, follow him everywhere and just appear out of fucking nowhere? I was so confused about the dad's quote-unquote fucking powers, but he just had the remote between his ass cheeks and clenching his ass cheeks together, which that was fucking bizarre. But I mean, I guess if it works. Also, I mean, the dad was pretty smart though at the end by basically getting up and doing the chores, like pretending like as if he's been doing the chores the entire day. So he gets to sit down and do nothing for the rest of the day again and make Darwin and fucking Gumball do them all. I mean, to be honest, I'm kind of surprised that the mum actually like believed the dad. I can't forget the parents' name. I think it's Nicole and Richard, but I could be completely wrong. But yeah, I don't know. That's basically all I've got to say. That was a good episode. I liked it. It was funny. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.